Welcome to the part 2 of the contract of agency series, and today let's discuss about rights and duties of agents. Okay. Yes, first we are considering rights of agents. Agent has a right to retain goods against the principal. Say for example, principal refuses to pay any charges, principal refuses to indemnify, or principal refuses to pay any remuneration which is due. In such cases, agent can retain goods and claim the amount which principal is bound to pay. Okay, now let's see. An agent has a right to get remuneration as per the terms of the contract. If remuneration is mentioned in the contract, agent has a right to demand, a right to get remuneration. Right of lien is something which we have already discussed in contract of bailment, contract of pledge, etc. Right of lien, as we already know, is a right to retain the goods belonging to somebody else. Here, agent gets the right to retain goods even though they are belonging to the principal if it is against certain charges which the principal is bound to pay. Okay, and therefore, agent has a right to retain the goods of the principal and demand payment of the money which principal is bound to pay. Okay, right to be indemnified. Agent has a right to be indemnified against any losses which he has incurred due to the neglect or want of skill on the part of the principal. Okay. Right to be compensated. Yes, any injury which is incurred to the agent in the lawful exercise of duties as an agent, as long as the agent is acting within the scope of the authority, whatever injury he has suffered, all those injuries he can demand to be compensated by the principal. Okay. Then the last one, maybe the most important one, is agent's right to enforce duties of principal. Say for example, principal has a duty to indemnify the agent, principal has a duty to compensate the agent, principal has a duty to give information, enough information to the agent. These are duties of principal, but at the same time, agent gets a right to enforce principal's duties. Okay, so I hope it's clear to you. Now let's see what are duties of agents, because rights and duties are two sides of the same coin. If you have rights, you have duties too. Okay, and therefore agents are having certain duties as well as far as contract of agency is concerned. Duties of agents. The most important duty of an agent is to follow the instructions of the principal. Principal is supposed to give instructions and agent is supposed to follow those instructions. If there is no time or there is no access to those instructions by the principal, agent is supposed to follow the custom, the local custom relating to that particular contract of agency. Agent is supposed to take reasonable care of the goods belonging to principal or any other thing in dealing with third parties and in dealing with anything related to the contract of agency. Agent is supposed to be careful. How much careful? He is supposed to be reasonably careful. I have already explained in my previous video that reasonable care is that amount of care which an ordinary prudent man would take in a similar situation. Okay. Agent has a duty to communicate with the principal. Agent has a duty to maintain proper accounts and render proper accounts to the principal. and agent has a duty to protect the interest of the principal during the contract of agency. Whatever he does must be in the best interest of the principal. Okay, this is not over. There are another set of duties as far as agent is concerned. Let's see. Agent has a duty not to deal in his account. He should not mix up his personal account with the contract of agency. Agent has a duty to pay sums received. That means as a part of the contract of agency, whatever money he receives, the money belongs to the principal, and therefore agent has a duty to give whatever money he has received to the principal. But at the same time, let me tell you, agent has a duty to deduct his remuneration from duty. Rather than duty, it is a right. Agent has a right to deduct whatever remuneration is due to him from the amount received, and remaining money definitely he has to give it back to the principal. Okay. He has a duty not to set up adverse title. Say for example, as part of contract of agency, if certain goods are given to agent, agent should not pledge them, agent should not sell them, agent should not create any kind of adverse title on the goods because goods belong to the principal. Okay. Agent should not use information. See, this information received during the contract of agency, an agent might be receiving different kinds of information about the principal. Those informations should not be used against the principal, either during the agency or after the termination of the agency. Okay, this is an ethical part of the contract, that he should not use the information received related to that contract of agency against the principal. Agent has a duty not to delegate, because an agent is appointed considering his personal qualities, personal capabilities, and therefore a job given to him has to be completed by him. He should not delegate. But there are certain cases, there are certain contracts which allows this kind of delegation. So with the permission of the principal, agent may delegate duties, but without the knowledge or the permission of the principal, agent should not delegate the duties. Okay, so these are the duties of agents. As I told you, duties and rights are two sides of the same coin, and therefore in a contract of agency where there are only two parties, that is an agent and a principal, what happens? The duties of agent is the right of the principal, and rights of agent are the duties of principal. Okay, so in next video we will discuss about the duties and rights of a principal in a contract of agency. Okay, I hope it's clear to you. See you in the next video. That will be the part 3 of contract of agency. Till then, bye.